In this video, you will learn how to make sure that sensitive data that you use in your recordings and business processes, such as login and password information, is kept secure. Storing sensitive data in RPA Express is implemented through the Secrets Vault component. The stored data is not shown in recordings, logs, system files, or bot configs, which allows sharing scripts with other users without the fear of exposing any secure data. To open the Secrets Vault in WorkFusion Studio, go to Window, Preferences, WorkFusion Studio, Secrets Vault. All records stored in the Secrets Vault are shown in this window. To add a new record, press Add and fill in alias, key, and value. Alias is the name of the record that will be used to distinguish it from other records, so it has to be unique and clear. Key and value store the information that will be used in recordings. These fields have been designed to store login and password information, respectively, but can contain any data you need to store. If you need to store only one secure piece of data, you can save it into either the key or the value field and leave the other one empty. For example, the record reports.xlsx contains only one piece of data, the password to an encrypted Excel file saved in the key field. Let's create a record named Gmail, where we will save email and password required to log into a Gmail account. The data stored in the key and value fields is encrypted, and you cannot see it when viewing the Secrets Vault or updating the records. To update an existing record, click on the field you need to change and insert the correct data. To delete a record, select it and press the Remove button. With the help of special variables of type secret, the bot can access the data stored in the Secrets Vault during execution and use it in the recording. Let's create two secret variables that we will use to log into a Gmail account. The variable email that will get the data stored in the key field of the record Gmail, and the variable password that will get the data stored in the value field. No actual data is displayed in the variables. Let's create a script to use these secret variables. We will open Gmail using Open Website Action and maximize the window. Then, insert the email using Web Element Action. Select the secret variable email in the dropdown. Click the Next button using XPath. Then, insert the password using Web Element Action. Select the secret variable password in the dropdown. Again, click the Next button using XPath. Finally, let's add a wait action to give the page some time to load. Let's play the script. As you can see, the bot used the email and password stored in the Secrets Vault to log into Gmail, and no actual data is recorded in the recording or the execution log. Let's publish the recording to Control Tower and see how to use secret variables there. Secrets Vault components in WorkFusion Studio and Control Tower are not synced. When scripts are executed from Control Tower, the bot pulls the data from the Secrets Vault in Control Tower, not WorkFusion Studio. So we need to create the same records here, too. Let's create the record Gmail and play the script we have published. The script is executed successfully, and no sensitive data is displayed in the results.